Every country has its law. They have a system of justice, judiciary system. Why? They wanted to put law so that the people be in the straight path. They know what are the evil consequences of the society. So, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the creator of the mankind, He knows much better than any experts. So He has put these directions in the form of the Quran, so that we can understand and try to practice how much we are able to follow. So, the purpose of the creation, that why we exist in this life, is clearly defined in the Quran. We may not need to ask any experts or any scholars that what is the purpose of this life. The purpose of this life is clearly defined in the Quran. In Surah Dhariyat, chapter 51, verse 56, Allah says that وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونِ. That I have not created the jinn, the unseen creation, which we believe as a believer, maybe the science haven't got that proof yet, but we believe there are unseen creation, the creation of the fire, and insan, that is the human. The reason for this creation is only to obey and to follow the commandments of Allah. That is the purpose of this life. And the reason is so that we may attain salvation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse 185, that kullu nafsin zaiqatul maut, that every soul that we have, it will taste the taste of death. And the verse continues that the final recompensation, the rewards of this soul will be given in the hereafter, and whoever among us shall save from the hellfire will attain the objective of this life. So this life that we are passing in this world is very subjective. That we must follow according to the law of the Quran so that we can attain paradise in the hereafter. We have to save from the fire. If we commit some crime, even in any countries in the world, they have a system of punishment. And this is the law of the Creator. We may do sin in our thoughts, in our minds, in our tongues, may not be apparent with the hands, or we may not do some crimes in public which have some evidence. But yet, if we see all these things, it has to be an accountability. If there is no accountability, there is no purpose of this life. So, the purpose of this life is to attain paradise, is to attain salvation by entering Jannah. How? We have to follow the Quran. So, let us now see that how being the non-Muslims or the experts, they see and they compare Islam with the secular system. Maybe you, many of you may know this book that Michael H. Hart, being an American, is one of the greatest thinker in past century, described as an astronomer, as a philosopher, and as well as a mathematician. You know his book, maybe some of you read it. But when I go through the book, I see through in a different angle. Michael H. Hart, his book was The Hundred, and it was published from USA in 1978. He was trying to give a list of 100 most influential people in history, starting from Hazrat Adam alayhi salam till the present man who is supposed to be in the 100 list. And he put, undoubtedly, our Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Holy Prophet of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to lead his list. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number one. The most influential man in history is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he gave reasons that why he chooses our Prophet, he being a Christian, why he chooses our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as being to lead the list of the world's most influential people. So he gave reasons that my choice of selecting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to lead the list of the most influential person in history may be argued by many people, or many may ask questions that why. But I have examined thoroughly on every individual, and according to my opinion, that he was the only person in history who was extremely successful in both religious and secular level. As I told you, that Islam says you have to lead a secular life. So being an expert in the last century, Michael H. Hurd, he described that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was one of the most influential people, person in history, because he was extremely successful in both religious and secular level. That is the balance in Islam. But we must see through what is the balance. And the testification is coming from an outsider, being an expert, doing research of the mankind history, till Adam alayhi salam, till the present man. So we came through and see what are the examples of the Prophet ﷺ have done for us. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 21, that لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَسُوَةٌ حَسَنًا. That verily, in the Messenger of Allah, you have the best example.